son.
For a couple days.
His plaster's weak.
Really, yeah, I see that. That's why I asked you what happened with that shit.
Well, that happens anyways, but his plaster's really weak anyways. That happens because they sucko the tile into the plaster, or they plaster the tile. Like, they put the tile on first, and they plaster up to the tile, like, in to the tile. So when the tile gets off on the high points, the weight, if the tile sticks together, the weight will just rip off.
But it wasn't something when you tore off the tile.
Huh?
It was already there.
Yeah. That's why I told him he needs to do it, because if it happens in other places, we've seen it. Gabe said he's seen it run all the way down to the bottom of the pool. It just depends on how it, like, how the plaster is. Sometimes it doesn't do anything. Mario, better? Is he training in or no?
He trained a little last night.
Yeah, he had one arm.
Nice. But he looked pretty good. He don't he's getting any problems. But he just wants to be careful. Make sure he's healed.
Make sure he's healed. Wake up, finish that, get that out of my hair.
Yeah, now you know how I feel. That's why I like to get stuff done. I hate stuff hanging like that. It's just always on your mind. It's like, I want to get it done.
Well, I just don't want to miss out on anything else that's coming up because I have that.
Well, that, and you don't tell me you haven't been like, it just bugs you that it's not done.
So I'm good because Pastor Robles is next week, so.
Get a pig hunting tag and go up hunting too.
Wait, what?
Paso Robles, the fort, Fort Paso Robles. That's where people go hunting.
Really?
Wild boar style, yeah.
Up north of California? Right?
Yeah, by the air, by the base, Army base, fort.
What? I didn't know that.
Yeah. I meant to go up there, but I never got in.
Oh, yeah?
But I've taken down a bear with bow and arrow.
Really?
Yeah.
Where did you do that at?
Fraser Park.
Where's that?
Fraser Park by 5 Freeway and like out towards, not quite to Bakersfield, but it's 5 Freeway. I went from Lancaster, so I was about a mile, an hour. From
so it's like almost Central California? Yeah.
No,
not that far.
Not even that far?
No, not even that far.
That's where I'm where I just
where you were.
Yeah,
yeah, right where you were.
I just worked out in Bakersfield. Yesterday I came back from the
night. Up in the mountains or?
Yeah, it's even closer than Bakersfield.
It's gnarly. There bears over there?
Well,
there's bears in these mountains here.
That's true.
They come to the alley all the time.
Like,
in the houses up in the hills, they're swimming in their pools and stuff.
Yeah, Glendale has that bear that
there's
came back.
There's bears up in these mountains, though.
Yeah.
But stay away.
Remember the big station fire? It burned all their food, so they started coming down to the foothills.
Oh, yeah?
So then I kept on asking people, you know, where's bears? Where bears? They said, go out to Fraser Park. So I drive into town, and I just start talking to people at the gas station. And he's like, one guy's like, you gotta follow me. So he takes me to his mobile home park.
Uh-huh.
And at the border where it borders the forest and his mobile home park, this bear's been coming in and digging up all the trash and just being a nuisance. So he let me set up.
Oh, yeah?
By the trash can. I had a blind. I went there two nights in a row. On Sunday night, I didn't see anything. Went back Labor Day and sat up on Monday night at 3-4 in the morning. I start hearing in the distant trash can and I see the bear. So now I'm like, my heart is pumping. So I have to call my wife. It's really here. It's really here. And then so she talked me down and then I was calm after that. And I just waited until it came to the closer trash can. Because they have wild apples there, so they throw the wild apples in the trash can. Just as not to bait them or anything, just
no,
regular.
So many.
So I had been practicing, all summer I've been practicing my shots. Compound bow. So it was a 20-yard shot. The bear was standing, looking over the trash can. And I waited hours for that shot to present itself, broadside, right through here. And the bear knew nothing of it until it had already gone through his body. So he was completely relaxed. That's why I went all the way through one side, the other side. Double lung.
Did you get his heart, no problem.
I don't think I nicked its heart, but it didn't need to. And the
That's where the term dead run comes from.
Dead run. It ran like 80 yards.
Because they're dead, but they're running.
Oh, yeah. And the blood trail was like real easy to follow because it's a double lung shot. And it was like somebody just spilled paint on the floor. But it was not a straight line. It was back and forth, circular, around bushes. And finally, it like went through these bushes by a dry creek bed. It went through that. So I couldn't get down. So I went around, jumped down into the creek bed, and by where it had jumped through to the, that's where I found him, come around it.
So what did you do with him?
Ate him. I still have bear meat in my freezer.
Really?
Yeah. Nice.
So did you clean him and everything?
Yeah, I field dressed him right there. And
nasty. You're nasty.
It smelled like
you're hardcore.
It smelled like wet dog.
Oh, man.
Well, I had to mentally be prepared, you know, if I was going to take
it. I never liked timing, man. I like fishing. I don't even like clean fish.
Yeah, you're like, No, but you have a responsibility. If you take one down, you got it.
Well, this is why I like fishing. I catch and release.
Yeah.
I'm not if I was a big fish eater or something, I would keep them. Even with that meat, most of the time I've had wild meat, oh my God, you hit that gamey spot, and you want to throw up.
I did a lot of research before I went out and took the bear down. The key is to field dress them right away, cool off. So you open up the guts and open up the skin. And
so there's
no enzymes
of getting the meat there
at
death.
Otherwise it gets sour.
Yeah.
And it was early in the morning, so the sun.
And well, see, in the old days, they used to leave that meat hanging up for weeks.
Yeah, I don't know.
Well, the reason they did that is to bleed it out, make sure all that gaminess came out of it.
Yeah.
You know, with the wild animals, you probably still could do that, but, you know, with the hormones, like the cows, they and stuff, they can't do that anymore. That's why people get food poisoning and stuff, even when they're not, you know, for the simplest, that wasn't the old days, that never happened.
People.
When you killed a bird, you ever watch that movie Shogun?
Shogun.
You ever see the Shogun?
No.
I think they crashed on the island or something. They were British and they ended up getting stranded on the island somehow or another. Or something happened.
Yeah.
I don't remember the whole show, but it was Richard Chamberlain. And he went and he hunted pheasant. He got these pheasants and he hung them up there to bleed for 2 weeks.
Really?
Out in the open. And one of the servants there was like, oh my God, it just stinks, you know, Japanese. We got it. Anyway, that's why they hung it up. But, you know, so they did that stuff. But the servant was.
Yeah,
I didn't see two messages.
Oh, yeah, one must be from Mario.
Oh.
I've also hunted deer in Montclair. No, Claremont. Montclair.
Deer
out there. Claremont.
You ready to open?
Sure.
4. 5. 6. 7. First step. Four. Switch it up. Standing backwards, nailing, what you want.
Mario must have got called into work, huh?
Yeah, he texted.
Who's that going to call?
My dad.
Oh.
I got a medical alert call. That's what those two calls were.
What's up with him?
He fell.
Is he alright?
Yeah. Couldn't get up, so then he couldn't get him. He was caught in the, walker. Who knows? He's probably just high. Oxycontin. On his Oxycontin.
Yeah, that's selfish. That makes you goofy.
Can't blame him, he's old. All of the same thing. Maybe not the extreme's doing it. I can see what you're doing. Why not? Might do some acid too.
Well, he's doing Oxycontin, Vicodin. And morphine. Is that good?
No.
Yeah. So he's ready
and
to try
medical marijuana.
He tried that too.
Did he?
Even the neighbors gave it to him. Try to keep your shoulders square when you stop. You should be square to the wall. Square your shoulders on that side. So you're like that. Yeah, there you go. his hand in front of his head. There you go. Think about putting his hand in front of his head, not even with the shoulder. His hand should be, as you come around to finish that circle, should be in front of his head a little bit. Oh, you had it right the other time. Grab the wrist. No. Grab the wrist underneath. There you go.
Even though you're still going, it's still a big circle. It's here. See the circle? It's not an L. It's not a her. It comes right off.
Just draw a circle right in front of you. Draw a circle. There. Underneath. Thumb all the way to that. There you go. Stop. You know what he's doing? You're trying to grab with that circle.
No, he's not trying to grab. I am grabbing.
No, he's trying to grab with the what? Do it again, Chin. See, he's trying to grab. That's wrong. You can't do that. Yes. If you keep going, it'll break free automatically. So, do it again. And bring it down to his center. There. You should be beside him though. You can't stay where you're at. Yeah, there you go. You gotta move around the side of him. Take it down to the center and it won't hang on like that. not, it's not the weights. He's grabbing. So when you
I,
go around.
I am grabbing when I do this. That's why he's grabbing. It's because when I do this, I'm stepping on line. I'm doing a circle and grabbing here.
Oh, okay.
Presents the hand. And then I just step
okay.
in. That's right there. So I'm
okay.
trying to show him how.
Okay, cool.
So even though you're doing the same thing as this with the circle, but I'm just opening my hand. So like how when you do Ikkyo, how you just, it comes right to it when you break, you know what I mean? It's just that wrist break. All you're doing is you're adding. So it's a circle, I'm leaving my thumb out. Big circle. And then it's right there. You know, and I could do this way, Koki Ho. Do either way, to me, a stagnant,
yeah.
I like to do it this way, because...
Yeah, but something's wrong in the grab, that's what I'm saying. So
yeah,
when you
I'm
grab...
I'm grabbing it wrong somehow.
Yeah.
So when you're here, so you're doing a circle, no?
No, put your foot, there you go. Yeah.
Yeah.
So bring the arm, let the arm fall in between your thumb and index finger.
A big circle.
There you go.
And it comes right off. Start with the thumb up right away, start.
There you go. So when you start, just widen your hand out. It'll come right to it every time.
Just make the catch.
Yeah.
You know,
just widen your hand out.
That's where it's going. And just get ready to catch right there. You just got to make sure you do a big circle with this one, because as soon as you start, if you go like this, someone strong is going to be able to resist that a lot more than if it's just too big circle.
No, so you didn't do that. That's what I was, yeah.
That's right.
There you go.
There you go.
Even if I hold on strong, I like to do a circle. It should come right off. Let's try and hold on. So you can see, as long as you do a circle, it's kind of hard to hold on. Okay.
So, being a doctor, you know the long muscles here, they only work linear. So when you do that circle and he's resisting, the only thing he can resist with is maybe this muscle here. So there's, you're using all that leverage against one little muscle because the rest of them can't do that circle and resist.
Yeah.
Yes.
Just this joint here.
Okay. Around with your leg, it's just nice. Here. Yeah. super close together, but you don't really want them super far apart either. You just kind of want to find where it's appropriate, where you're able to sit.
But if I have it here and I lock it up first,
side too.
Yeah.
And I work for a company. I work for my dad. And like, always, I'll have like a month off, no work, and then all the work will hit at the same time. And it's like, well, you gotta try to get it all in there while you can.
Yeah.
So it's like 7 days a week it is.
Yeah.
So I can get everything paid off. I'm trying to save enough money to start paying off the truck.
Mm-hmm.
I got everything else paid off.
Yeah.
And I figured that, you know, we might have a really wage job. And that good, so paid off the truck.
Yeah, all those things cost.
Yeah.
Well, I'm not looking forward to getting a new car. Driving my 20-year-old car almost.
Oh yeah, so long strong?
96. With 200 plus.
Oh,
yeah. Hey, Dad.
Yeah.
I drove my truck over 300 miles. Never had anything wrong with it.
Good
old Ford.
Ford 300,000?
300,000.
Like F-Series?
Yeah, man, the F-150 was an 89, had over 300,000 on it. Only thing I replaced on it was the timing chain, and the only reason I did that is because the water pump leaked, and I just would have welded there, I put the timing chain. Because
you're supposed to do it like every 100.
Never had to do it. No, that's a belt, this is a timing chain. It's different. But that's the only thing I ever...
Fords, yeah, they tend to make really good trucks.
That white truck, it's got 178 on it.
Yeah, they tend to make really good trucks, but they're small cars.
Well, I don't know about that. Their cars now are good cars.
Good, huh?
I think so. Mm-hmm. My daughter's got a Ford Explorer. No problem.
Good.
Did they have problems with them when they first got it?
Actually, they did it. They had to put a tranny in, but it was under warranty, so it was brand. They put a brand new tranny in.
So
that was it.
Around like the old days, huh? Old days, they were.
I think that was for Mark driving it with the trailer, because right after they pulled the trailer, and he had an overdrive, I think, and burned the trailer.
Yep. Wait, I got Toyota.
Say what you want. Ford and Chevy just as good as Toyota, or better. We'll see. Mine will still be running while yours is in the yard. Already had recalls on yours.
Toyota's had a little bit of trouble with the runaway cars.
Yeah. Well, they got more than you hear in the news. That's the thing. They got a lot more than that. A lot more recalls than what you hear about.
They said those people, they said that they checked the sensors.
Yeah, I never believe that. I think
not that police officer, though, on the freeway.
Yeah, but that was a Lexus, though, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was
Lexus. I know, but it was a Lexus. It wasn't the Prius like they were harping on the Prius.
No. It was the Prius. No, I don't know.
Oh, I know which one you're talking about. That was an older guy, though, but there was actually a police
officer.
Well,
there was a
highway patrol officer.
Who was on the phone.
But it was a Lexus.
Okay, yeah.
And he was doing like 120.
Yeah.
And he couldn't stop.
He could not.
And he ended up killing his whole family.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was horrible.
Yeah.
Why would you just turn off the car?
I that's what I'm wondering. This
no,
is a highway.
I don't think they could.
This is not, well, like that. You almost got locked in that Lexus, remember? Grandma's Lexus.
Yeah.
You couldn't. This Lexus, they were little. They were maybe 10.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
And they put in, you know, they were in the car and they had the windows cracked a little bit. And they were gonna be right back at
the
shop.
Yeah, windows cracked.
Yeah, like the dog. Like a dog. Like
yeah.
My mother-in-law.
Dog
my mother-in-law. And so they it was getting hot, so they were going to, you know, they're human, they can open the door. Well, in this case, they couldn't open the door, because every time they do it, the locks would be locked.
Huh.
And they couldn't get out, and the same thing happened to Mom. She said she got in that car, the same thing happened to her, she couldn't figure out how they'd get out of the damn thing.
That's like Christine, then.
Yeah.
Yes.
I remember, like, this lady on my sister. And of course, they were all far away.
Yeah.
And all these people were coming out of the shop just looking at us, like,
yeah.
Should have said something. We can't get out.
They probably almost broke the window to get you out.
Actually, I think we were scared and we hit.
Okay.
Because we were little.
Car.
I was like 8.
Yeah, you were little. But anyway, so there's problems. There's all kinds of problems there.
I mean, you could have put it in neutral. Maybe they couldn't put it in neutral. I'm sure they thought of all that.
I this is a highway patrol officer. I mean, this is a highway patrol officer that did this. So
yeah.
He had to know. Shut the
know
car off.
Neutral.
Put it in neutral.
Yeah. So all those didn't work.
Apparently.
Yeah, because with the push
because he was on the phone. He's saying, yeah, I can't stop this freaking
push button ignition. So turning it off doesn't, I don't know. And then neutral somehow didn't also work.
I would have to go to Mr. Park.
Yeah, oh yeah, I would have
started
spinning it and
yeah.
something and just slowing it down somehow.
Scraping the side island.
I don't know. I don't know really what happened there.
Yeah.
Strange.
But I was in that truck, I remember when I was standing Taylor, and then the throttle cable got stuck.
And your Chevy?
It back from the, yeah, dad was working on it, and I got the throttle cable got stuck. Makes me, that was all.
Yeah, because he left. Because he left something on it.
Well, I know, but I'm saying I didn't think about turning the car. But I freaking slammed. He just replaced the rotors on it, and I was like,
"Well, you had to save yourself."
And then I threw it in the park and turned it off.
There you go.
And I ran out, and I remember the brakes, smell the brakes burning. He's just like, "Well, there goes those brand new rotors. Took better than dying."
Yeah.
I think I walked home.
You had to save your life.
Yeah. Car you can replace.
Me? No. It's okay, we broke up, so I'm glad it's not car. Just kidding. Oh, boy, got some yummy good.
Yeah, it looks good. The only thing when you do that again. Can't see when you're on the side of it. Don't be okay. Stop. Go back a little half step. Right that there. Don't be that way.
Oh,
keep your arms. Keep your hands where you can see them.
Yeah, you told me that.
No, the other way. The other way. The other way. Just keep it just up on your forehead. There you go. Yeah, that's good. Feeling the back of his arm going across your shoulders and the back of your head. If you're not, you're probably like this instead of like this. You should be here, just like a sword.
All right. You're pretty good on that one. What time is it? We got an hour, right? We're gonna do a kite nage. Has he done kite? I know Mario.
I don't think Chen.
No.
Is that heaven and earth?
No.
Okay. That's Tenshi Nage.
So you're gonna do the same thing as you were doing Ikkyo. So Kokito, you drop me low. Now, remember how watch my hand down here? Remember how we're saying that's the thing to catch?
Yeah.
So what you're doing is this hand's going palming the head, this hand's making the catch. I was doing just a year roll on this arm. You're stepping across the back. That's kind of okay. So that's kind of why I chose to do this one. To remind you about that. Making the catch. So you're here.
That's good, yep.
That's it.
On the arm, you need to step with that, your left foot.
This foot?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. Step in to it.
Yeah, because there's also a hidden strike there. There's a knee there. So what, you're walking extended again. Six extensions, you're just moving forward with your whole body.
Yeah. Yeah, they get, they become the same thing over and over, just in different little angles and iterations. Could have dropped another. Why would he willingly go down?
That's not willing. It's not willing.
You can't.
It's this again. Yes. Yeah.
Okay. See, it's still there.
You're putting, as you're doing that, all your weight is going down into the ground.
Okay.
There's no way he can hold you up with one hand. But at the same time, the reason he's hanging on is to control.
Control your head. Because I want to punch you.
Yeah. So if we're here,
so right there, you're like, wow, I just lost my, I'm completely out of control.
Uh-huh.
But this is my lifeline. This makes me feel safe.
Yeah.
Because
you
were completely out of control.
Right there, just in the lead.
Yeah, you could have stepped on me,
so
put your knee on my back.
Yeah. So even, it's just.
Because I was trying not to go down.
Yeah, so it's here. And as soon as you get here, see, you already got the bend from Kokyo. So
and
all of it. So it's gonna just bend.
So that's ego. But if you try not to go down and do what you did, you'll probably do a flip.
We'll see.
Try that one though. So it's down and back and around. And when you do that, it's like the old judo. Yeah, but if you just do it hard, he'll follow that flip. I guarantee you he will.
You're saying here.
You're doing kite, but
when
what
I
I'm
pull
saying,
back.
What I'm saying,
it's
the
back
circle.
Far.
It's the circle.
Yeah.
Here, it's
like this, so because he's coming way down and it's a circle. See, right there you almost fall. But if it's an honest attack and you just kind of do it without thinking about it, you'll go.
Oh, yeah. Momentum.
He just came and grabbed you and tried to punch you.
Yeah. And you were intent on attacking,
uh-huh.
You wouldn't be thinking, I'm going to flip right now. You know,
I'm
you
like,
just all of a sudden you're on the ground.
Yeah, because right now I'm set.
Right.
It's solid.
Right.
But
right.
That's not how it really is.
Right.
The
exactly.
First
thing
you
so. Yeah. That's true.
Even if your part is.
It doesn't really matter. I'm just
that
saying that
it
can happen that way.
You know, that close kill breaks the energy.
Okay.
And you can just follow that. You know, so the better you get this technique, as soon as you dip,
uh-huh.
You just follow it.
Okay.
As soon as your opponent dips, you follow it.
Yeah, there you go.
That Koki Ho, it just breaks the energy. So it's real easy to take someone down. You know, and it's very rare we're going to get in a fight too where someone's going to hit.
Yeah. Because that's not
yeah.
How I'm going to offer my hand.
Yeah.
I'm going to offer with motion.
Well, either or, we're going to the same hand, just focus all the energy
yeah.
In the wrist. Like, go ahead, go. Let's see what you got.
Exactly. And we talked about that before. It's never neutral.
Yeah.
It's either they're going to pull a little bit or push a little bit. It's
yeah.
Not stagnant.
Yeah. Yeah. But practice stagnant. That way, if you can make a technique happen from stagnant motion, when you get motion, it'll be that much better.
Yeah, the idea behind the stagnant movements that we do is to create motion. To learn how to create motion. Because when you learn how to create motion, you can add to the motion that's already given you. So when he grabs, it's creating motion. So even if he stops, and he's neutral right now. Now I'm going to create motion. You know what I'm saying? So if you learn how to create motion, when there's motion, when it's actually, he's giving me something.
Yeah.
You know, I can add to it by learning how to create motion. So that's what we do the stacking thing.
Okay. Cool.
See, square up though. Don't get sideways when you do Koki Ho.
Just step straight line. Boom, and I'll just pivoting your hips. Stepping back, straight back. So your shoulders are square, side by side. So you do. So you're stepping right beside right beside my foot.
Yeah.
And then just straight back.
But that left right shoulder should be forward. Yes. Now, put more weight in the back foot a little bit. There you go. 60-40 on the feet.
You want them touching. That little bit of touch is
because
you off balance and your feet are wrong.
Okay, just for illustration,
yeah.
Do Koki Ho and turn. No, grab. Just do Koki Ho, grab it. And do turn like you were with your shoulders back, that shoulder back. Okay, now go down. It's okay, now stop, go back. Now, do Koki Ho and try to keep your shoulders square. Now, put that right shoulder more forward and more weight in the back foot. Now, down. There you go. See the difference?
Yeah.
There's a huge difference.
They're all at the centers.
Okay.
All right here. So, here and here. Match up in my center.
Now, more weight on your feet and more weight in the back foot. There you go. There you go. Push down. Nick Hyden on you. There you go. You didn't go across the back enough. Square that shoulder. saying is, you did that fast, they'll actually flip and fall when you do it like that. So practice keeping those shoulders square when you do Kokyo hold. Because it's just you, there you go, and put more weight evenly, there you go, evenly. 60-40 at the most, 60 in the front, 40 in the back.
That ratio.
Yeah.
Almost 50-50.
You want that spine
here.
Straight up and down. That
That's
when you
that, like 60-40.
Yeah, and then so when your shoulders are square like you did, you felt the dip. I mean, you went down really easy.
Yeah.
Whereas when your shoulders are back, all of a sudden you got to make up
like
all
like
that
this.
Difference. Yeah.
Yeah.
Back to the basics, the fundamentals.
There you go. Well, put the foot back. Wait. Put the foot back. Back. There you go. Square the shoulder up. More.
Awkward.
Hips. Nah. Just turn your toe out more. You're the front foot. There you go. Now square your hips and your shoulders. So when you do Kokyo Ho, that front foot, you can have the, you want this angle here. You want your toes pointing out away from you. Keep it there. Keep it where it was, yeah. So don't let the heel come around because you'll end up like that every time. Now square up. There.
So this is how I want it.
Yeah. See your shoulder. Don't. So when you come around, you gotta think about it right now because you're coming around like this, and you're letting your shoulder come all the way back like this.
Okay.
You gotta
don't
stop.
Don't let it go.
So just keep
stop.
In mind that you know this,
like
this shoulder here, the outside one that's not being grabbed, is the one you gotta control. See, I'm square. My feet are here. I'm square. My shoulders and hips are square for the walk.
Pay attention to this outside shoulder.
Yeah.
Okay.
Good. There you go. Yes. And then. You go. By doing what you're doing, you know, normally, but if you're not getting that blend properly,
mm-hmm.
Let's see if I can show you what I mean. So from here, okay, now, like when we do, sometimes like with Ikkyo, okay,
yeah.
We actually slide out.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
But the reason you're not doing that here because you're actually turning them sideways so you don't have to step out because you're doing this. There, he's already there.
Yeah,
because
he's
at the right angle because he's actually turning with you like this.
Yes, he's making room for you. Because he's going sideways.
Yeah.
How do you turn off crossing?
Huh?
Trying to remember how you turn off crossing. The only way I can think about it is hard.
How do you knock it?
It has a hand switch.
No.
Well, it's a blend.
Yeah, you can go like this.
That's similar.
Yeah. You gotta switch or. I mean, there's more advanced ones down. Awesome. So if you hang on, you go across the back. Here. Across the back.
Underneath.
That was a good one, so I'm okay.
You wanna try crossing?
Yeah.
You're just switching is all you're doing. You're just switching. You're going back to the same side anyway. So.
Okay, so which way do I
go? So you're going to grab.
Let's go slow and show me. weight I'm rolling.
So
yeah,
dropping.
So it's the same thing.
Yeah.
You're just switching back to the same side.
So we're not doing the advanced one. We're doing the switching hand one. Okay.
So it's pretty much the same thing as if you're going to be tilting out.
Okay.
Change that movement. Base and D.
Right there.
Good. So with that, I lead down crosshand and step in.
Yeah, because it's a prelude. Now this would be a prelude.
This one's more for motion, too.
Yeah,
a little bit. But
this is a prelude.
Yeah, this is what it's prelude to. Exactly. So he throws a punch.
So it's here.
Okay, this one's more for motion.
So if you see that motion, now he grabs across that midstep. So it's the same, it's a prelude to that motion.
Okay.
So we'll start sagging.
Yeah.
We'll just kind of go with it. And then we'll add, I think, the ninth, a little bit of motion.
Okay.
So it's here, it's like you're doing Koki Ho. This hand, you're not grabbing.
Okay.
Cut.
You're cutting. So it's here. So right now we don't have motion, so it's a little bit harder to get here. But if you need to. Yeah. So lead down. They get that lead down. Like you hitch right up to the ground.
Bend your knees though. Freehand comes over the top.
Okay. So it's here. You're catching the arm.
Yeah. Here.
So I'm over. This hand is catching right
down here.
And then it comes right. So as you, as it's here,
yeah.
Same thing to the trap.
Oh.
So it's really simple. It's not complicated. So if we're cross hand,
yeah.
You're going to do Koki Ho. As you do Koki Ho, send this through here.
Okay.
Like this, and then down.
Okay.
See, because all you're doing, you're just making it. So if this was crossed, the same side, you're doing this to this.
Oh,
so you're just making it the same thing by cutting.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Same thing.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, cut. There you go. There it is.
Yeah.
Just try to cut more because you got to get him down. You just got to really put your weight on it.
The hitchhiking hand. No, the hitchhiking hand is the cross hand.
Because
we're doing it so stagnant right now,
yeah,
that if we were grabbed, to come here,
cut. And to cut, it's hard. Like,
yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You have to have a really good, you know, so in order to help,
yeah,
aid it, get him down when you want. Then your cut only has to be mediocre.
Yeah.
Because you helped it out with this hand.
Right.
You know, because you got to think if you're trying to control,
mm-hmm,
you're not going to let go of that hand.
Yeah.
About me doing this.
Yeah.
You know, by the time you let go, the material needs control. So it's just, you're leading them down with this hand, you're breaking away.
Your knees.
Yeah.
Step back with it. Step back. Step back.
There.
Now step back through.
There you go.
Yeah. So it's just like Ikkyo, right? You follow the hand with that leg.
Cause you gotta make room for yourself.
Okay.
Or else you're gonna do it.
Okay.
bend over though. Try to loop up. Bend your knees.
Bend from the knees, okay.
A little bit of bending back, right? Just not all of it.
Yeah, there you go. That's it.
Still leading low, but I'm giving me enough time to get here to clear. So that way I have good balance. I'll take you around.
Yeah, your shoulders still have to be square when you end up end the cookie hook too. That's to pay attention to.
So go ahead, as soon as you start leaning, go ahead and start leaning down. There you go. Now you don't want to bring it way over here. You just want to bring it there. So that the air needs to work. If this is, you start right over this, we have to finish all the way across your body.
Yeah, here.
It's here. Okay. You know. Yeah. You gain a load about here, bring it to about your knee. Okay. Then cut it.
Try this side again, guys.
So just bring it to your knee. So, good cut, drag it on the ground.
Yeah.
That's just to help, because that's just to help get them off balance already so they're not so strong. Where you're fighting against all this upper body. If you have them down here, it's broke. You know what I mean? You're not fighting against your back. See, it's a little bit too far. Upper butt right here. Right here. Kind of transitions. Right there. Make sure that even though we're doing that, the shoulder making circle is as big as possible.
Okay.
It feels a little
tight.
A little tight.
When you think of the downward thing here, again, this is a prelude to punching. The same move, you're just going to transfer it into punching, whatever. So if he punches, this is the blend. Just like what every other one would do, right?
Yeah.
Right? This goes all the other ones.
It's good they all build on the same thing.
So if he does this, this is the blend. Now it's down across the back. It's always been one of my favorite techniques because you can actually do this. You can actually do this here.
And a person who doesn't know how to roll is just going to fly on their face.
They're
going to
fall on their head or their neck.
Right there.
I mean, when I did this to a student one time, and I just kind of got a little too with him. He should have known how to roll, but he didn't.
Okay.
I mean, he did, but he didn't roll right.
For the moment.
So when I did this, and I went, like, he went right on his head. Dude.
Yeah.
And it hurt him. He was out for a little while, so.
So, yeah, with motion,
it's,
the technique's going to be more
punch, just
straight down. But since we're a little stagnant here,
How many?
It's 51.
Okay, let's go ahead and add a little motion to it.
Alright. See if we're ready for that. So,
so
you're punching.
It's the same, it's the
you're
same. We're not just punching the grab.
Okay.
So what I'm doing. Okay, so give me a little motion. So
cross hand?
You're leading, yeah. So
okay.
All you're doing is you're leading a little bit.
He's down.
Okay. So try to lead them. Because if they're coming in for a grab, try to lead them down a little bit. Okay? Okay, you're just going to let that flow. So here.
There we go.
Okay.
So that lead that he's doing is the same thing we're working on with Kokyu Ho. Okinage.
Uh-huh.
Right? Remember we were working on it and grabbing the head?
We did the
yoko and bringing the head in.
Yeah. Oh, yes, yes.
Okay,
yes.
It's the same thing.
Okay. Bring it in.
So you're baiting them and you're going to get them off balance.
So remember we were saying.
You're reaching and then once they get it, it's going back.
So when we were working on that, you were doing this. Right?
Yeah.
In this case, you're not going to do that.
You're offering that hand.
You're going to let them come away from you a little bit. Remember I told you don't let them get away because you're going to go beyond me?
Uh-huh.
You actually want to do this. In this case, you want to actually turn and then cut, you know, so you want to get that hand.
Oh. There it is.
So it's the same blend though, it's the same blend.
It's good that they're all the same. So you get to work on the fundamentals all the time.
So you're going to go, I'm going to show you too much. So, just remember what Sensei said. Give them something.
Yeah.
As soon as I get it, take it back. So lead down, not way down, but you're just gonna lead down to your one point, to your waistline. That's a good. That's a good lead. A little maybe a little lower. Just right in that area. And then when you're here, all you're doing is turning and you're taking it. So my momentum is gonna go this way. You're catching my arm.
So once you do Kokyu Ho, it's the same as the standing you've been doing. It's the same thing.
So when you come in, I'm going to do this.
And then it's the same from there on.
Okay. Ready? We're going to go real slow.
Okay.
Let's see it.
Same thing. There you go. Step through.
There you go. Step through. So
I remember to have to step forward this time.
So even though you're leading, you're still
you're
leading, you're dragging your foot back. Instead of stepping forward, what do you prefer, stepping forward?
No, because that's what I was saying. Remember I was saying with Kokyu Nage, the only thing we did different is we actually stepped forward so I could capture your head. This one, I want to lead you out like this.
Okay.
So I want you. I want to actually get some space here and then down.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So I'm not coming towards you.
No, you actually want to go out.
Circles.
So, there's foot back.
Okay. Getting it, but make sure your blend is all the way. You're doing a half blend again. Quarter blend, actually.
Yeah. So, I need a full Kokyu Ho.
Yes.
Okay. As soon as you get to the side, get the hand in there and cut. They're going forward, you know?
So,
just do it. You'll be okay. Just start.
Just do it.
And think about a full turn, full half turn. There you go.
It doesn't need to be perfectly straight.
Kaiten Nage is a corner throw. If you're throwing to the corners.
So even though I'm here, it doesn't have to be a straight backwards throw.
Yeah.
I'm leading you to the point to where
anywhere.
I feel comfortable making that cut. And so it could be here.
Kaiten Nage means directional throw. It's directional.
Yeah.
So wherever you want to throw, you can throw.
This is good around Dory because you can get them. And you get someone here.
It's an eight directional throw.
There's someone coming behind you. So it's hard to hit them.
Okay.
It's a fun technique.
Yeah.
So don't get too caught up in the higher shit behind you.
Okay.
Just do
a
cut. Do the cut. And wherever it ends up, I won't hit the wall. There you go.
Just turn. Just yeah. Turn again.
Okay.
Turn again.
There you go.
Okay. Just keep the circle going.
Keep your circle going. Because
I have this.
Yeah.
Yeah. Just keep it going.
At the one point, I can turn from any.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. You can step faster than I can.
Keep turning, turn, yeah. See, well, that turn even adds more to it because you're adding.
Yeah,
because
I'm
yeah.
Spinning them. All right. This way. Hold on.
So you're going to start here. You're going to blend back. So it's kind of like a backwards Kopio. Do you know what? Yeah. So even though you're dragging this foot back, by the time when this foot comes out, all you're doing is you're pivoting. So you drag, and then you pick on that foot.
No.
See what?
So I drag.
Now,
then this one.
This come back. Yeah, there you go.
And this hand does a chop in. That's what that was. So you're here. So when you're here. Dragging this foot back and leading you. All I was doing was pivoting and down.
And then pivot from there and put your other foot, drag your other foot back. Like walking back with Kokiho, the same one we practiced. So you're walking back.
Here?
No, it's not that turn though. Here, do it. Do it.
Here.
Here. Do it. Watch here. See, now that's what he's talking about. He's opened up, but now watch how he finishes. There. See that back foot? Go back to there. Where you were. Right there? No. Your foot was out there. Right there. This back foot is now the pivot point.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So when he pivots, you're going to take your outside foot back. Just go.
So I'm here, I'm taking. So it's almost like a double step.
I'm opening. This is now my pivot point.
Okay, see here.
And you did a double step.
It's here,
down.
So, you come, here, down.
Because with the motion, you're going to be running around. So I got time. So I'm getting you here, I'm getting that cut in. As soon as I get that cut in, I step back. It's like, it's almost a double step.
It's going to feel like it, but it's not.
Yeah, you got to get that foot around.
Yeah.
So you're going to open. You're dragging that foot back.
Okay.
With the hand. There you go.
Stop.
See how I'm here?
And this is my pivot. This is how I come over now. Cut.
Now drag your foot back. There you go. Down.
Okay. Yeah.
It's kind of weird.
No, this and then that. This is the pivot foot.
Hey, you just gotta get around. You gotta get out of your way. You gotta not interrupt that flow.
See, it's here. Okay, so I'm.
It's still the same pivot. See, you still. Go back.
Right here.
Look, you're still pivoting on the same foot. So draw back.
This one.
There's your pivot point still. Still your pivot point. There you go. Now, this foot follows. There you go. So it's the same foot you're moving on. Over the top. Cut. And cut.
I gotta try this out.
Grab.
the foot
word right.
So,
that's right here. To the artery.
It's right under.
Well, don't even. Yeah, you can think of that, but just think of the sword tip again. We're talking about energies up here, not here. You're thinking of a sword cut.
So as he comes, it's even in your hands up like you are. That's okay, because I went like this. Okay, so if I did that with a sword and I flipped it over, cut back.
Well, that's kind of what you're doing.
Yeah, you are doing that, but that's what I want you to do is think about the sword that will make that circle better for you. Because right now you're doing all kind of linear.
With motion, when there's motion, it kind of tends to get a little bit more wild.
Okay.
Like, everything's the same, but what I mean by wild is it's not so cut and dry, straight forward, straight back. Like, when you do a circle, in order to take their balance, it might be a full circle, mm-hmm. might be a half circle.
Okay.
You know, it depends. So you've got to feel it. Okay. That's what I mean by it. You can sit there and practice
Say
it all. Yeah.
Exactly.
But
your foot here,
when motion
no.
gets in it, it's goes kind of like a window. You know, you want that stagnant
okay.
in your head, but once there's motion, you got to kind of go to where it works.
So why'd you stop? You could have kept turning. You could have turned until you're comfortable getting that. Turn until you're comfortable getting the hand over the top. Cut. Yeah, just right from there. Cut. And then there you go.
See,
so that cut your steps down too.
Yeah, even the footing can change. Like how we're doing a double step.
Yeah.
If I lead you around in one. I don't need that.
Right. That was one big circle right there, and then you step through at the end.
You know, mm-hmm. just
you don't have to adjust.
Yeah, it depends on where you cut. It switches your feet up too.
Okay.
Good.
Keep turning though.
Okay.
Turn.
As soon as you do those, yeah. anything that you did wrong there?
I was trying to come in before the turn was complete.
On top of that, you were leading me down,
yeah.
and when you went to go put the other hand, you led me back up. So, with the lead, here, okay.
And from the outside looking in, what I seen was, you started here, and you got up turning, and then when he came around to this point, you went like this, straight out. You went
turning.
Linear. You want to keep turning, big circle. Do that. If you do that, see, I barely touched you, I just have to kind of guide you, and you'll go.
Cool. Can't stop.
Where's the lead? You can lead down, or you got to get them off balance enough, or you just take them down. Because if they're off balance,
yeah.
just that tap on the arms and get them to fall. So, depends on which one you want to do, which one you want to do.
Well, whatever.
Well, do what he's saying. I'm not saying not to lead down, but I'm saying keep the circle going.
So, big circle.
Yeah, it's even better when you do that, actually. I'm just lazy. My knee's not bendable right now, so.
And don't feed that. You're not feeding that to me at all. You don't want me to grab your wrist.
Yeah.
You're baiting. You're baiting him.
Yeah.
So you're not going this way.
It's like the greyhound chasing the rabbit.
There you go.
Nice. Yes. See the kind of energy that was involved? Became?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You're baiting.
Just put your hand, just lay your hand
up. What I was doing.
Yeah. Hey, actually put your hand up here and then drop it when you're ready.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Drop it. You kind of stop. But yeah. Slow down a little bit.
Okay. Slow down.
Well, you're small, so I have to. This is I'm going fast.
Yeah.
That's me and you. You're controlling the pace.
Okay.
You're doing your speed. I have to keep up with you. This is because I'm moving fast. Try to keep up with you. Doesn't mean you need to move fast.
Now you need to slow down then because
you're
moving too fast. And over the top. There you go. And step through. Yeah. There you go.
That's all it is.
Yeah. Okay.
So
this thought of actually baiting you actually helps.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's what you're doing. You want to take I had it.
It's the same. It's the kind of idea. It's the idea of the greyhounds chasing the rabbit thing.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Yeah.
So if your intent is to grab and hit,
right?
Back up a little. Your intent is, especially when you offer something, is you, there's a target for you,
yeah,
and you can hit or kick or whatever you want, right? But if I let you get close enough, see?
Yeah.
So you're like,
but
you're wanting,
kind of,
yeah,
you're
fight onto
because
it.
I'm giving it to you,
yeah,
but I'm teasing you. So I let you actually touch it. There. So that's why it works, because that's what baiting is. You're keeping it just there and let them grab it, but don't let them grab to the point where they can actually pull you back.
Yeah.
I don't want to stay here like this and do this. And then he's got me in control.
Yeah.
I want to keep it moving.
I want to.
And you want to look like you're scared, right?
You yeah.
Do that thing
yeah.
where you look really scared.
Yeah. You want to like, oh, here he comes. Right? You don't want to give any aggression back, because that'll stop you. See what I'm saying? So if you don't give any aggression back towards the person that's getting you, it's like, uh-oh.
Yeah.
Okay. Try that with time.
Right now, you're joining a little too fast for your capability to switch in your hands, so slow it down a little bit more. Keep turning, switch, keep turning. There you go. Don't stop the circle. Just keep turning.
Just keep on turning.
Even when you're switching, even when that hand's coming over the top, keep turning.
All right, one more both sides, and close it down.
All right.
Down.
Keep turning, don't stop turning, keep turning. There you go.
I'll do that a little bit.
Yeah.
I'll keep that momentum going, but sometimes you have to do that. It lets you get the feel for it.
Keep turning. There you go. Yeah.
So even though you're cutting, you're still
turning.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. Just do a circle. Okay, let's go.
Fundamentals down, so it's a good base.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It's a strong house. So.
Yeah.
Every sport that you do has those fundamentals. That you
yes.
Do. I don't care what level you're at.
Yeah.
If those fundamentals are weak, you're not going to be very good.
Nice thing, though, is everything is based
well,
on the fundamentals.
I'm saying the same thing in every sport,
yeah.
though.
Yeah.
In boxing, the fundamental is keep this foot, you know, whatever foot, your lead foot, don't step, you know, turn at your hips. Those things, you know, jab, you set that jab in, don't lift your chin up, you know, things that just continue on through the whole process, the same here. So there's only about 5 or 6
that's
different
moves
that you really need to as far as your footwork.
Yeah, that's good.
And the rest just falls into place,
because
it's all pretty much the same. You
yeah.
just do different techniques off the same footwork.
Yeah.
So the last one you're doing was more of a hand-con movement.
What's the difference between, we call it Kokyo Ho, they seem to call it Tenkan.
Oh, you mean this movement?
The switching. Some places call this the Tenkan, don't they?
I don't know.
Because when they do Kokyo Ho, they have something like this.
That's Sayanagi.
Oh, okay. Tenkan, I don't know what they mean.
Tenkan is a circle.
Yeah.
So
it might be a whole range of things.
But anyway, so what you were doing instead of the, well, like when you started, it was